Yeah, I must say, you can see the smile on my face. It's nice to finally be able to beat them in an ICC tournament. This is the seventh one I've played in, and we haven't actually gotten close. Like you mentioned, there has been a few nightmares in the past, but to finally put that behind us and to move forward is really exciting. No, I think it's definitely crucial for us. I think we've always known how strong we are, and we know within the team we've got match winners, and we know we've got one of the best bowling attacks in the world, but sometimes at these events we haven't really showed what we're capable of. So to finally do that, I think it's one of those things where we kind of, if you had a monkey on the back, it's now done and dusted, and I think this would just give us the boost. We need to know we can go, because we said this year around, we want to go one step further than the semi-finals and take a World Cup trophy home. The thing for us this time around is it's one of the things you don't need to touch base on it. We know that that's the reality, but for us, I think this year around, we just decided that we want to spend a lot more focus on us and what we do well and what we can do as a group, because that's something we can control. We can't always control what the opposition will do. So I think this is maybe a different this time around, is that we just decided that we know we're good enough. We just have to play and have fun and enjoy. This is a wonderful opportunity. I think it's the biggest Women's World Cup that there has been so far, and to be part of it is such a honor. So I think for us, it's just a time to use our talents and enjoy it. I must say, there was a lot of nerves. I think definitely Chloe did pretty well in the 19th over to when she hit the six. I think that really took the pressure off. And then just before she went out, she said kind of she doesn't want to actually leave too much runs for the last over. I still say to her, I think get one and make sure that you're on strike for the next over. But I mean, she went out with a bang, and I just thought, like, for me, I just had to breathe, take some time, and I just needed to tell myself, like, I know that I'm good enough. It's my 100th game. I've played enough games in my career to actually be able to step up in crucial moments, and I think to finally do that and contribute to the team is really special.
And when that six went over the rope, what was going
through your mind? Yeah, there was a time when I thought it actually just went up, and I kind of held my breath for a little bit, and I didn't know if I wanted to blow, just like, oh, just keep going. But I think I saw the feeler went up, her eyes lit up, and then I just saw it kept going. So I think that really took a lot of pressure off, knowing that we then basically just needed the one of three deliveries. And with the field up, I knew, like, I'm just actually, if it's a good ball, I can still respect it, then there's still going to be another two to go. Worst case scenario, we run on the last ball. But I think for us, it was just good just to keep calm and just know that we've got what it takes to win a game. Yeah, I think that's reality with T20 cricket. You're going to have some brilliant games and brilliant days where the ball just flies, and other days where you have to just, it's not always as easy. So I think once you realise that you're probably going to have more bad days than good, you need to enjoy the good ones. And for me, I think it is something, though, that we've had a discussion. I know I've worked on it. I know I can back myself in situations like that. It hasn't always come off. I think sometimes in the moment we tend to overthink or make some stupid decision while we're out there. But for me tonight, I think it just all clicked. And I'm really fortunate. I think the experience probably from being one of the most experienced players and playing in these events paid off tonight. I think for me, everybody probably that knows me know that religion is pretty important for me. So before I usually go out to bat, I say, God gave me this glory and he died for me on the cross, and now I play for him. And in that moment, I just also said, please just be with me. Thank you for for being with me before when I hit the six, because that was probably the hard part. But now just stay with me to make sure that I can finish it all for the team. Yeah, I think at that time it was more just the nature saying, I think we've done really well. The bowlers has bowled brilliantly, and for once we've actually been outstanding in the field. That was one of the areas that let us down in the pod. But she just said she just wants every batter that walks into the crease tonight to back themselves and know that they've got a job to do and they can finish it off. And I think the way she and Kapi set the example, that brilliant partnership in the middle, that definitely got us close to what we needed. And we know we've got batting depth. So I think for them it's just important to take it as deep as possible. And every batter that walked into the crease just know that you have the ability and you can win a game for your country. Yeah, that's probably a question more for the selectors, captain, coach, but from a teammate's point of view, I just think we know what quality batter she is, and we've seen her in the past, and we know what she's capable of, and I think she's really worked hard. She's probably one of the people that spends most time in the nets working on a game, and there's no lack of work ethic, but I think for her, we know she's pretty good at both. She hits quite straight, which is really important, especially when the ball's it's still moving around. So for us, I just think it's one of those things, like with the batting lineup, we don't always want to yo-yo around with it too much. I think for her, knowing that she's going to walk in and bat at three is quite important, and that she now know exactly how to plan a game around it, where in the past it's been coming in early, batting later, and I think now she really understands what's needed for her in this very moment in time.